What's going on, everybody? Dato Doi here with another Dragon Ball FighterZ themed video. Over the course of this channel's lifespan, I've made a lot of videos covering Dragon Ball FighterZ, and usually the goal of those videos is to help newcomers get acquainted with the systems in Dragon Ball FighterZ so that they may go on to become competitive players themselves. Now, usually those videos cover the game itself, or they cover the terms that people use to discuss the game. This time, however, I'm going to be covering the controllers you use to play the game, and the common misconceptions that come with them. Let's start with the most important point of this entire video. You do not need a fight stick in order to be competitive in Dragon Ball FighterZ. In fact, the game was clearly designed with controllers in mind, and this is coming from somebody that's going to be spending most of his time playing FighterZ using a fight stick. Now you may be asking, if that's true, how come at every fighting game tournament I've watched, all of the top players are using a fight stick? And the answer to that is simply they prefer using it. You see, the one thing most top level fighting game players have in common is that they've been playing fighting games for a really long time. And because of this, they most likely learned how to play fighting games at the arcade, in which the only way you could play the game was with a joystick. So because they were doing it for so long and got comfortable with playing on a joystick, just because the arcade scene here in America died out, doesn't mean that their love for the joystick did. And that's the second point to this video. The best controller for you is the one you prefer. If you've been playing with Xbox controllers your entire life, then you'll probably be most comfortable with an Xbox controller. Same goes for people that grew up with PlayStation. And the ironic part is, if you don't have experience with fighters in the arcade, then getting a fight stick might actually make you worse at the game. The entire point of a controller is that you want it to feel so natural to you that you don't want to think about it when you're playing. So if you try learning a new game and a new controller at the same time, you might find yourself getting confused and frustrated, especially after paying $200 or $300 for the fight stick itself. I mean, seriously, those things are expensive. And you might say, well yeah, but I could get a cheap one, which is something I would advise against heavily. Again, this is something you're investing in so that you can play a game you love. And if you really like the game, chances are you'll be playing a lot. And when you play, you need to use your controller. And cheap fight sticks are not built to last. Those things will break on you numerous times. So if you are going to get a fight stick, just save up and spring for one that's better built. So now for the remainder of this video, I thought I'd show you the controllers I plan on using for Dragon Ball FighterZ, and why I prefer each one in different scenarios. So here's my lineup of controllers. You got your standard Xbox One controller, a PS4 pad, and the Mad Catz TE2 for Xbox One. Now, like the overall theme of the video would suggest, I'm gonna go through each controller and list my pros and cons for me personally. Let's start with your basic run-of-the-mill Xbox One controller. My two favorite things about the Xbox One controller is the shape and feel of it, and the fact that there's not a lot of setup involved. If you want to bring it over to a friend's house, you don't have to make room for it in your bag, you can just carry it along with you if you really want to. When I do use it though, I have to use the analog stick, which isn't preferred for me since my D-pad is broken. But overall, this is still the controller I use when I want to do something casual in the game, like maybe play through the story mode or arcade mode, and do a couple of the trials for my favorite character. My one major gripe with the controller, however, is the button layout. I think Dragon Ball FighterZ actually handled it much better than a lot of other fighting games that you can play on the Xbox One, but still, for some reason in my brain, it doesn't make a lot of sense to have the attack buttons not over each other and directly next to each other. I don't know why my brain works like that, but if I have to use the triggers and bumpers for anything in a fighting game, then that's gonna take a lot of mental concentration on my part, and I'd just rather not think about it. Alright, let's skip the PS4 pad for now and move directly on to the arcade stick. So my first pro for this controller would be that it feels very natural and solves the issue I have with the Xbox One controller and having to use the bumpers during the fight. All of the buttons here are laid out for you in order, and you can customize each button to perform a specific action. Though I guess you could do that with the Xbox One as well, but you'd have to use the bumpers for something. My other pro for this controller would be that it just feels rewarding to win with. I know that sounds kind of weird, but this controller is very satisfying to use. All the clicks and button presses makes it feel like you're doing something, and the overall feel of it is very satisfying. I plan on using this controller for when I'm really trying hard to climb that ranked ladder, and if I'm ever doing like an online tournament or something that somebody's hosting, I'll probably use this controller as well. The cons of this controller include its size. If I want to go over to a friend's house and play some Dragon Ball FighterZ over there, I'm not going to lug this thing all the way over. I'll just take my Xbox controller, or if he's playing on PS4, I'll just take my pad. And I know a ton of people like to sit with their fight sticks in their laps, but for me, I like to have it set on a table for something, so it really dictates the way I'm sitting when playing the game. Now onto the final controller I use, that being this PS4 pad. Now I got this controller on a whim. I literally walked into GameStop and asked if they had any, and they said yeah and showed me this Mortal Kombat one. I'm not really even that big of a fan of Mortal Kombat, I just really wanted to try out a controller version. And I ended up really liking it a lot. To me, it feels like the perfect combination between a normal controller and a stick. It has everything that's satisfying about a stick, and it has the perfect button layout, and it's very easy to take with you wherever you go. And it also plugs into the PC, which is what I use this thing for. So I'm gonna be using this thing for everything on the PC version of Dragon Ball FighterZ. That includes beating the story mode and climbing the rank ladder. For a con, I'd say this controller is probably the easiest to break out of the three, but if you treat it properly, I don't think that's really an issue, so I don't know. I'd still say I have more fun using an arcade stick, but I would say if you want something in between an arcade stick and a controller, definitely check these things out. Well, that's going to be it for me. If you have a favorite controller that you use for Dragon Ball FighterZ, please feel free to leave it in the comments below. I'll be down there as always. And if you like this video and channel, then it would mean a lot if you could hit the like button and subscribe. I'm Dato Doya, and I'll see you in the next one.